this face is not real. This one isn't either. None of them are real. I could keep going. In fact, here are some more random faces. Hey guys, I'm NiceMark and today I want to show you the results of a small experiment I did. A few years ago, I heard about machine learning, deep learning, neural networks, and so on and so forth. I didn't pay much attention to it because it was before I started programming. Since then, there have been a lot of improvements and new projects in the machine learning space. Recently, I came across a project called DCGAN, made by some people from Nvidia. The faces it can generate are incredibly realistic, and I thought, how about I try to generate Minecraft faces? My first try was with DCGAN by Siraj Raval. It didn't quite work, but at least there were some results, some resemblance of faces. The next project I tried was DCGAN, which stands for Deep Convolutional Generative Adversarial Network, which probably doesn't tell you much, and that's okay, it doesn't tell me much either. I'm still doing this more as a hobby and I plan on giving it more attention soon, depending on your guys' interest in this. So make sure to leave a like if you would like to see more experiments like this. What I'm basically doing is giving the network a dataset which contains example images that I would like to generate, and I tell my computer to start doing research, and after some time it will output some result, maybe a good one, maybe a bad one. I had to resize the faces to 16x16, they're 8x8 by default, but the generator really quickly had problems and started generating just noise. I'm using male faces here. So I resized it to 32x32, and it worked. Here are some images from this test. Then I trained it for some more, just about 2300 epochs. And here are the results. I'm not quite sure that training it for a longer amount of time helps. After all, these are just Minecraft faces. They are 8x8 by default, and that's just 64 pixels in total. If you compare it to a real face, there's really not that much customization you can do in a Minecraft face. And now for the female faces. It started like this, but soon after, the tone of the generated images changed to pink, purple, basically girly colors. This change started happening since somewhere around epoch 1950. I found it amusing since the faces started looking the same. Same colors, same eyes. Did I train it for too much? I kept going for around 3000 more epochs, and the results are pretty much the same. There were occasionally different faces present, but there's only a handful of them in a generated test image, which is an 8x8 square, so 64 faces in total per image. Up until this point, other than in the intro, I've only shown the results of 10,000 input training faces. It's hard to build your dataset. While getting the skins, I got banned from Planet Minecraft. I don't know how long the ban is for, but it's been a few days already and I'm still banned. I've probably been downloading them too quickly. So I found another site with a large collection of skins and I'm currently downloading them. It's taking forever since I'm downloading them more cautiously now to prevent getting banned. Things like this can take a month, to be honest. But it would be very useful for future research. Anyway, I tried testing with 100,000 faces as input, and here's what I got. Are the results better? Are they worse? Same? Let me know in the comments below which dataset you think produced the best results. I didn't train the 100,000 one for a lot of epochs. Due to the bigger dataset, the training time is also bigger, and my GPU, while still good, pales in comparison to a GPU used for research by people that actually know what they are doing. If you're wondering what the deal with epochs and training time is, you cannot expect to get a result within a few minutes. It can take hours or days to get a result. This is why processing power matters. It takes a lot of it to get something. As a side note, I've looked at my electricity bill and it's funny, every month it keeps going up. And that's it. I could just make a video saying, hey, here's some micro faces I generated with a neural network. Okay, bye bye, thanks for watching. But I wanted to make one which showed a little more of the process, the results, the technology behind it. Let me know in the comments what you think about it. Anyway, for now, you guys tell me what you think. I have some other projects I'm working on which are similar to this one. I'm doing a lot of testing, but I would also like to hear your feedback about it first. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later. Bye bye.